Gail, Doktor. I'm the minister here at Jackson Community Church, which is David and Ginger's home church while they reside here in Jackson. And I've had the pleasure of getting to know Cassandra and Derek as well, and Chad to have a family part of our community. And I would also like to introduce Pastor Matt Pinsker, who is a childhood friend of Matt's and has reached. Oh gosh. Sharing this ceremony together today, and we are pleased to welcome all of you here as the beloved community that is bearing witness to this promise that is being made today. Just a couple of things that we would add. Restrooms are back here, but the wedding cart is coming through there. If you absolutely need one, now it's time to run to it. Or maybe go around back. But basically, turn off or silence your phones, and no photographs with phones or cameras during the ceremony. This is an unplugged ceremony. We ask that you be present here to bear witness, but not take your screen with that, because there will be photographers that are doing all of that, and if your screens are in front of their photos, they get pictures of your screens instead of what they're trying to capture, all right? So we would like to see your beautiful faces, and have you see our wonderful wedding card here. Those are our requests. Welcome. So I'm going to check out Brett and we'll see how we're doing. Oh. Now, who gets the song of today?
We do.
And before we go to the second reading, we have a special performance, also chosen by Cassandra and Derek, by a soloist from the church named Bob Parker.
Help to people on their way as Cassandra and Derek the aisle. And Eric looks up and gives a smile. The love that flows between them fills the churchyard. The family and friends at her side, he really is the blessed bride. With love and pride, they lead her. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. With the priest and the family who lead the prayers, we say our lines and they say theirs. He guides them through the ceremony, oh yeah. And in this house of God above, we join their hands to show their love and say those most important words of yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thank you.
sickness and in health, in hardship and in ease, as long as you both shall live.
I do.
And now Matt has some words to share with the couple.
Derek and I grew up going to church together. We grew up in the church youth group, and so I've known Derek for most of my life. But I don't really have a specific memory attached to Derek until Derek was in seventh grade, I was in ninth grade, and we were at a church youth event, and we were at a camping trip, I think, and I was standing with some other guys that I knew, and I didn't really know Derek, and all of a sudden I turned and I saw this little guy. He'd come stumbling toward me. He was wearing a Chicago Bears baseball hat backward, and he was just coming right over at us, and he goes, "Hey, Ellis, what's good?" Love that the Bible talks about is a force. It's a power. And despite knowing that, we still often sell it short compared to other powers that are in the world, and we should not do that. We say it's great, but then we underestimate it, and we should not do that, because we know that love can snap your head off. We know also that it can keep you going when nothing else will. And we know that love that animates you and drives you is sending you out into the world together in one purpose, to love each other well, and with or through that love to build and strengthen and multiply the love that you give to support and strengthen your families, your friends, your colleagues and co-workers, your country, and the whole of the world. God bless you guys. You are a blessing to all of these people.
May we all be filled by the words that Matt has given to us and the commission that we are offered here today to go out with love. This is the time when Derek and Cassandra exchange their own vows that they have written to each other. Derek.
Given in token and pledge of your constant faith in each other and your abiding love for one another. Rings are an outward and visible sign of the inward and spiritual bond which unites your hearts in love.
And so we would ask you, the beloved community, to please hold your hands up, palms up, and become part of the blessing of these rings. that will symbolize this covenant being made today. Please join us once more in prayer. Gracious God, bless these symbols of covenant promise that they may remind Cassandra and Derek of your encircling love and unending faithfulness, that in their life together they may know joy and peace in one another, encircled by your love. Amen.
Make sure you look.